Hello mga motorista! Welcome to another episode of Motorista Adventures. For this video, we are here at Toyota Cagayan de Oro. And for this video, iko-compare natin ang 2023 Toyota Hilux E and 2023 Toyota Hilux G. Tignan natin kung ano yung mga spec differences nilang dalawa para kung nag-iisip kayong bumili nitong pickup trucks na to, mako-compare nyo and mako-contrast nyo sa when it comes to its features. And at the end of the video, I'll give you the pricing dito sa Toyota CDO. If you are interested to know about these pickup trucks, tara, this is the right video for you. Samahan niyo ako. Let's go. Okay, so simulan natin sa harap ng dalawang pickup trucks na to. Yung nasa ating left side is yung ating Hilux G na white, and then ito naman yung ating Hilux E gray color. Now, looking at it from the front, very similar silang dalawa, no? So, when it comes to their headlights, they are both the same and also sa kanilang grill. So, kita nyo naman, parehas lang sila ng outline ng grill natin. A-type grill siya. You have halogen headlights, no, for both. And then, LED yung ating fog lights, which is really nice. Now, dito naman sa ilalim na part, same lang talaga sila ng forma, no. One thing that I don't like about both of them is yung headlights lang natin, hindi mga LED. So you have your big Toyota logo there, no. Ito yung ating Hilux G. One thing na madi-differentiate mo siya agad sa ating Hilux na E is yung ating mga tires. Tingnan natin. You have all-terrain tires. So these are Bridgestone Dweller all-terrains. And naka-alloy rims tayo. And aside from that, you have 265 by 65 R17 na tire setup, no. 112S yung kanyang speed rating. And disc brake tayo dito sa harap, you have big pistons here for your brakes and double wishbone suspension. Dito naman sa ating Hilux E, same suspension setup lang sila. Okay? Ayun, so parehas lang sila. Unfortunately for the E, you only get steel wheels. So if you are going to buy this E, no, for a cheaper amount of price, you'll have to spend more for rims, no, kung gusto mo talagang pumogi yung ating Hilux E. But as is, steel rims lang siya, and not pretty at all, no. So American Dweller all-terrain pa rin. So same lang ata to ng rims, no. Ayan, let me see. 265 by 65 R17, same tire lang sila na ating Hilux G. Another thing that you'd notice sa kanilang dalawa is parang matangkad si Hilux E. Number one dyan is wala siyang step board, no? Kaya siya matangkad tingnan. But basically, both of them, same height lang silang dalawa. Now, when it comes to their profile on the side, parehas-parehas lang sila. Chrome yung ating side mirrors. Power folding silang dalawa. Hilux dito na badge, same lang din, Hilux. And chrome din yung ating mga door handles, right? Moving on to the back part, so both of them get slip spring suspension as with the Toyota's pickup trucks. Meron din sila mga mudguard na standard drum brakes, pero hindi mo makikita dito kasi because of the design of the steel rims. So big downside yan kung Hilux E, but again, this is cheaper than the G. Is wala pa tayong bed liner, so this gives you an option to get a spray-on bed liner. Ito naman a standard, meron na siyang kasama na bed liner. Which is good. You don't need to spend anymore for a bed liner. Meron din silang mga rear defoggers here. Parehas lang sila meron ng mga rear defoggers. Okay, so at the back mga motorista, kung hindi ka masyadong meticuloso, hindi mo makita yung differences nila because they basically look exactly the same here. One thing na meron sa Hilux G na wala sa E natin is yung reverse sensors. So kita nyo naman, you have this plastic part here. Doon sa kabila, wala lang. Plain lang yun. Oh. Tingnan nyo. Ito naman, meron tayong Hilux here. Pagdating nyo dito, walang Hilux dyan. Gray pa din yung ating rear bumper here. Just like that one, pero medyo beefy lang siya because, again, you have that design, no? Dun sa ating rear bumper. Now, for the Hilux E, for the 2023 model, I think for the 22 model as well, meron na siyang, yan, meron na siyang reverse camera, no? So, yun, hindi siya ganun kalayo dun sa ating Hilux E. Parehas lang sila. Meron pa din tayong high mount stoplight, okay, on the tailgate itself. And kung bubuksan natin to, yep, wala siyang tailgate assist for the G. Tignan natin. Okay, meron siyang tailgate assist, no? Yan, kita nyo na mga motorista. So, easy. Ayan, one hand lang. Oh. Comparison doon sa E, medyo mabigat talaga yung ating tailgate. Right. Now, when it comes to the mechanical side of things, they are the same mechanically, no? From their chassis to their suspension, nothing different sa kanilang dalawa. Si Hilux G, yung ating spare tire, is the same what's on the vehicle. And I do assume na parehas lang din dun sa ating Hilux na E. So, this is white color. So, I think this is super white. And then, ito yung kanilang gray metallic na color from Toyota. Now, let's talk about the engine because yung dalawang to, parehas lang engine. This is Toyota's 2.4-liter engine. Gets similar power, no, at 150 PS and 400 Nm of torque. Now, for the E model, unfortunately, when it comes to the transmission options, no, wala kang option for automatic dito. If you want automatic, go for the G model. Yun lang yung merong option na automatic variant. So, either manual, 6-speed, or automatic na 6-speed yung pagpipilian mo dito. Of course, merong price premium yung ating automatic than a manual transmission variant. So, itong dalawang to is manual transmission. So, I'll give you the price, no, also for the automatic version nitong Hilux natin. So ito yung mga interior features ng Hilux E. Number one dyan is wala tayong leather steering wheel. This is urethane lang siya. Meron pa din tayong controls for the screen. Ay, ito pala. Ito yung controls natin for the screen up front. You can see your digital speedometer para mga motorista. Yan, kilometers per hour, 0. And then yung mga trip natin, andito din siya sa ating G. As expected, the Hilux E, very basic lang yung kanyang aircon controls. So manual aircon controls lang siya. Dito din, you have radios that are basically the same sa ating Hilux G. Meron siyang Bluetooth, radio, USB, and meron pang iPad dito. Meron siyang USB port here, and meron siyang smart device link. When using this head unit, no, of course, meron siyang Bluetooth audio, pero it's not as responsive, and yung animation niya medyo stuttery in comparison to the other, no, head units on the lineup. I think this is much better yung kanyang color pag white kesa blue, mas modern siyang tignan. Yeah, very basic, no, head unit, no. I think this is around more than a 7-inch display, around 8-inches to na display. But again, quite basic compared to the higher models. So ito yung susi pala nila. So switchblade type. Okay, lock, unlock, and meron siyang alarm button. And when it comes to materials here, mostly plastic material, high quality plastics naman siya. We have silver finish dito, and then marami tayong mga lalagyan. Now for the E, automatic din siya na up and down yung cutting windows, which is nice. Power folding din yung ating side mirrors, which is also really nice. Meron tayong mga grab handles on either side, dito sa ating A-pillar. And meron siya air conditioning dito, no, sa ating meron din tayong compartment here, pero hindi siya damp, and I don't think meron siyang ilaw. Okay, 12 volt accessory outlets, dalawa dito. Meron tayong limang blank switches here. You have your traction control button off, and then manual transmission for this model. 6-speed automatic na siya, yung reverse natin is paharap. And then meron tayong drive modes here. Meron naman tayong dalawa, power and eco mode. So, pag eco, meron siyang indication sa center screen. Okay? And yung screen natin is 4.2 inches, no. Yung mga size niya is analog gauges lang. So, kita niyo naman, you have your temperature gauge on the left side, and then fuel gauge sa right side. Speedometer on the right side, and also rev counter natin dun sa kabilang side, no. So, very nice naman yung design niya, although it's still analog. Ayan, meron din digital clock, day and night rearview mirror. Meron tayong mga dome lights which are incandescent pa. Yan, sunglass holder. Wala tayong vanity mirror here. Passenger meron, pero na wala siyang ilaw. One thing to note is pag Hilux G and Hilux E, unfortunately, ano siya, cloth seats na tayo dito. Unless you're buying the top of the line ones, no, cloth seats lang siya. So, one thing to note also is that power adjustable lang yung ating seats. Okay, so recline lang siya at slide, no. So if you're quite shorter, medyo mahirapan kang mag-adjust, or you just put a pillow here. Is meron siyang tilt and also telescope, no? Yung Hilux E natin. Okay. So, moving on to the second row. Now, one thing that's missing here is, kung i-compare ko siya sa Nissan Navara, is wala tayong rear air vents. Which is sana maganda kasi medyo mainit dito sa likuran, medyo malayo yung ating vents dun sa harap. So, meron tayong 4 kilogram hooks. And ito yung ating mga pockets dito and dito. Okay? So, meron pa tayong 4 kilogram hook dito din. So, very convenient yan. And split type yung ating seats dito, no? You can fold this seat alone, upward. And you can also fold this one. So, 60-40 split siya. Usapang price naman tayo sa dalawang to. Both of these vehicles are quite different when it comes to the pricing, of course. So, let's start with the Hilux E. Yung Hilux E natin is priced at 1,174,000 pesos. Base price lang yan, sa unit price lang niya. Now, same lang to ng price dito sa CDO because same price lang sila sa lahat ng dealers, no, dito sa Pilipinas, which is good. Yung ating Hilux G naman is priced at 1,303,000. So, yung 1,303,000 na yan is for the manual transmission. Kung gusto mo automatic, 1,379,000 naman yon. So, medyo may kalakihan yung difference from the manual to the automatic. I assume parehas lang sila ng specs dito, just the transmission is different. Now, dito naman sa ating Hilux E, no, medyo may kalakihan din, around 100 plus yung difference nila when it comes to the price, no? So, lalagay ko yung price difference ng dalawa. So, if you have the option of these two, no? Mas marami tong features, mas marami siyang mga add-ons. But again, when it comes to basics, no, mas okay siya kasi if you really want a work truck na medyo could be your daily driver lifestyle truck na din, is ano, okay na din to siya. And it's quite cheaper than the Hilux G. So ayan mga motorista, yung ating comparison ng ating Hilux E, Hilux G. What do you think? Would you buy the E over the G or the G over the E? When it comes to considering the price and the spec features that I showed you. So, let me know down sa ating comments mga motorista. So, big thanks to Toyota Cagayan de Oro mga motorista kasi pinavideo nila tayo dito sa kanilang yard. And as always mga motorista, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, subscribe. Click that notification bell for more videos in the channel. Once again, this is Adrian, Motorista Adventures, and I'll see you on the next episode. Bye!